Hello, everyone. Welcome to Windows 10 for Beginners. This is the Carson City Library's second virtual class. My name is Vanna Bells. I'm the librarian in the Creative Learning Department, where we offer programs for people of all ages. I normally offer computer classes in person. I look forward to those again sometime in the future. I work best answering questions, people's questions right then and there, and showing them what they need to know. But let's do our best here for this class in Windows 10. What is Windows 10? It's Microsoft's newest operating system. What's an operating system? It's software that manages the computer's memory, processes, hardware, and other software. So basically, when you buy a computer, if it doesn't have an operating system, it's a nice, shiny black thing on your desk that you can't use. So you need to know what operating system you have. The system is a Microsoft, and so their newest version is Windows 10. So Windows 7 and Windows 8, you can still use those, but if those computers break down, Microsoft is not going to fix them, so they're no longer supported. The other competitor, so if you were buying a Mac computer, which is owned by Apple, you would be on the Apple operating system called the iOS. And I'm not very familiar with their computers, so I don't even know what's the newest iOS. Okay. So I wanted to show you why it's also important to know an operating system. So the screen that you see on your left is what the user interacts with the computer. It's what you and I see. But if you're working in IT or computer design, that's what they're actually working with. The screen on the right, that's all the computer code. So it's their job to make our lives easier by offering a graphical user interface. So when we click on an icon, it opens up a program. There's multiple windows when you use a computer. Like windows meaning screens on the computer in the monitor. So I know computers is very confusing. There's lots of jargon and lots of words can mean the same thing, but I'll do my best. And then there's also pop-up menus, which I'll also go over. And because we're doing short videos for this class, the next video you're going to see is going to be about the start menu.